Good morning, bond people. I'm Jim Levis. This is BVTV, looking back at last week in fixed income markets and ahead to the week. So, overnight in Tokyo, perhaps a game changer, we've seen the 30-year US Treasury yield go above 3% for the first time since January. There was a big sell-off in government bond markets post Trump's victory last week. Now 10-year US Treasuries are yielding 2.2%. That's been driven by a rise in inflation expectations. We've seen inflation swaps now at 5 years trade above 2. We haven't actually seen 2% inflation on the Fed's preferred measure, the PC deflator, for 5 years now. So people are expecting higher inflation in the States and much more government bond issuance from a Donald Trump presidency, where we get $1 trillion of stimulus and loads of tax cuts as well, especially for corporates. The period people are looking back to is Reaganomics, where Reagan came in and did both of these things to stimulate the US economy. Now, the difference between then and now is that Reagan had lots of fiscal headroom. Debt to GDP under Ronald Reagan was just around 30%, whereas nowadays Trump inherits debt to GDP ratio of maybe 80, 90% in the US. So more bonds, more inflation from the US economy, a really bond and friendly environment for fixed income. And we've seen a big sell-off in government bond markets around the world, continuing overnight right now. Other implications around the world. I just got back last night from Ireland, and it's really the story that dominates all the papers all day long in Ireland at the moment. What does the Trump victory mean for the undocumented 50,000 Irish workers living in the United States? But more importantly, tax inversion. If Donald Trump cuts corporation tax from one of the highest levels of the world in the States down to around 15%, that makes Ireland's 12.5% look a lot less attractive, relatively. And all those US companies that have domiciled themselves in Dublin and elsewhere in Ireland might start to move home. And they employ around about a quarter of Ireland's public sector workers and provide a lot of the tax revenue for Ireland as well. So big implications, not just for Mexico and Brazil and other areas of Latin America where they're worried about illegal immigrants and the impact of a Trump government, but for the rest of the world too. Now, thinking about the other areas of fixed income markets last week, obviously TIPS and inflation-linked assets did relatively extremely well. The big loser, though, was emerging market bonds. For although we saw a rally in some of the commodity prices, copper up 11% over the course of last week, emerging market bonds, and especially those, as we know, issued by Mexico and other Latin American countries, did very, very badly indeed, with both bond yields rising and local currencies collapsing too. So a bad week for EMD. Credit, though, did generally quite well, with the exception of some of those sectors particularly exposed to Trumponomics and those areas. I'm thinking of healthcare in particular in the US, where Obamacare, if that is scrapped, then healthcare companies potentially lose some of their revenues. But that was the only area of credit markets that really didn't do so well. Right, I look ahead to the week ahead. What are the three things that we're interested in over the course of next week? Well, it's the last week of opinion polls before the 4th of December Italian referendum. We also have Austrian elections on the same day. If Trump means the end to austerity and the rise of populism, maybe that's what we also see in Europe. And at the moment, the polls are suggesting Renzi will lose that vote. So a rise of different type of politics in Europe as well. We saw that expectations that maybe Marine Le Pen does better in France led to French bonds doing extremely badly last week. Secondly, great note here from RBC Capital last week, there's going to be a change to UK inflation. The CPI measure is going to start to include household costs, housing costs, a weight of around 16% or so. That could have a big implication, the rise of a new measure, CPIH, new bonds to be issued. The UK is unique in a way in having RPI as its benchmark for its inflation-linked bond markets. There is some expectation that market might be gradually phased away and we end up with a new bond market here in the UK. Finally, it is the 10th anniversary of Bond Vigilantes this week. We were launched in 2006, just ahead of the great financial crisis. We've written our second book about it now. You can probably get hold of a copy. What you can certainly do, though, if you like our stuff, go onto our Just Giving page. We're trying to raise over £10,000 for Cancer Research UK. Have a great week. All the best.